Today on the Home Winemaking Channel, I'm going to clear up some confusion for a lot of new winemakers, and we're going to talk about what is the difference between primary fermentation and secondary fermentation, and we'll also explain maybe why those aren't really the right terms that you should be using. If you like content like this, make sure to click the subscribe button below and swing by my Patreon page, patreon.com/makewine. The term primary and secondary fermentation is really common in the home brewing world where you're brewing beer. It's also used often in kit wines, juice concentrate kits. Also when people make country wines, when you're making things out of maybe unconventional fruits or even vegetables or roots, and again in mead. But when you get into more true wines where you're making wine from grapes and you're following relatively traditional methods, it really gets sort of confusing. And that's because you've got things like actual additional types of fermentation involved, like malolactic fermentation in addition to alcoholic fermentation. And those can happen at all sorts of different times. It's not always in sequence. It's not always one right after the other. It could be happening at the same time. So the reason most home brewers will use the term primary and secondary fermentation is going to be really simply because they're using what's called a primary fermenter, which is often a bucket. It could be a Spidel fermenter. It could even be a stainless steel tank to do that initial fermentation where they want that really vigorous, yeast just really munching away at those sugars like crazy. And that's really not the time when they want to add things like more aromatic hops or dry hops. So they'll transfer to what they'll call a secondary fermenter, which is often a glass or plastic carboy. It's sealed up. It's got a little neck with an airlock on it. Of course, if you're a winemaker, you know these too. And that's when they'll add things like I said, dry hops. And when there's not a lot of yeast present, those aromas produced from those dry hops, which are basically the same as any other, the hops you might add at another time, but those aromas will stick around a little bit better. That yeast isn't really going to metabolize a lot of these estery, really nice smells coming off of there. Mead makers will do a similar thing. Whether they are or aren't using hops, they're often using lots of spices, and they'll ferment in their primary fermenter where things are getting rowdy and crazy. Got all this yeast. Often it'll settle into a thick sludge on the bottom, and they'll take the mead off of that sludge, and that's when they'll start to add things like their spices. They might add some orange peels. They might add even things like chocolate. Those mead guys get a little crazy. I think there are really no boundaries when it comes to mead, is one thing I've learned. But they'll do that in the secondary fermenter when they don't have a whole lot of yeast left. Often the point at which they'll transfer from primary to secondary will be either when that brew is dry or close to dry. So when either, you know, all those sugars have been consumed or most of those sugars have been consumed. Where things get a little gray with winemaking is, let me start by saying, if you walk into a winery and start talking to the winemaker, you usually won't hear these terms, primary fermentation and secondary fermentation. You'll hear terms like fermentation, which refers to alcoholic fermentation. You'll hear terms like MLF, or malolactic fermentation, which refers to a bacterial fermentation which converts malic acid into lactic acid. You'll hear terms like aging, but it's really just not cut and dry. Some beginner winemakers might consider alcoholic fermentation primary and malolactic fermentation secondary. But again, where things get confusing is sometimes you'll co-ferment. So you'll actually introduce that malolactic bacteria during your alcoholic fermentation. So those are actually happening at the same time sometimes. So what I normally like to use is, like I said, the word fermentation. And if we're talking about a red wine, that usually means you're fermenting on the skins. That's when you have it in this, could be a bucket, could be a bin, could be a barrel. And that yeast is converting primarily sugars into alcohol. And this fermentation always refers to alcoholic fermentation. When we're done with that fermentation, or sometimes not done, we'll usually press that wine, transfer into another vessel. We'll let that wine settle out. A lot of like lees, dead yeast, fruit particles will settle out. We'll pull that wine off again. So now you've got a relatively clear, free of solids, liquid here. And to me, that's really when the aging period starts. So we first had what we call fermentation. Now we're getting into aging. Or if you're talking about a white wine, you might call that clarifying period, where you're just kind of waiting for that wine to clear up before you can get it into the bottle. Now, as we get into this aging period, a lot of things can happen. You can move that wine into an oak barrel. You can introduce malolactic bacteria to allow that malolactic fermentation to happen. You can eventually start to do things like blending the wine to kind of dial things in. But in general, we'll call this the aging period. I think to make matters a little bit more confusing, and why we don't really use this primary fermentation, secondary fermentation terminology, is you'll often ferment a white wine in a carboy, which a lot of home brewers would call that a secondary fermenter. If you want to try to keep using these terms, maybe what I would consider the differentiator is, when do you get that wine off of that bulk of yeast? So even if you're fermenting a white wine in a carboy, at some point that fermentation is going to settle down to a crawl, or ultimately settle down to a stop, and you're going to want to get that wine off of that pile of lees. We call them the gross lees, when it's a thick pile of dead yeast cells and even fruit particles. So that transition, if you want, you can call that the transition from primary fermentation to secondary fermentation, or just primary fermentation to aging, which would be a more appropriate term for winemaking. I hope this helps you out and maybe clears up some confusion. I know it can be really difficult, especially if you're coming from a home brewing atmosphere into a home winemaking atmosphere, where brewing, you have all these different terms. You call this sludge at the bottom, you call it the trub, we call it the gross lees. You might work in specific gravity, we might work in bricks. So all this stuff kind of similar, but it's just almost like a different language. If you have any other terms that maybe I didn't mention in this video, I'd love to hear in the comments below. Thanks for watching.